25 useless human body parts you can actually live without. 25. Rector pili muscles. The rector pili muscle causes the phenomenon we commonly refer to as goosebumps. There are small muscles attached to our hair follicles which when contracts causes the hair to stand up. In most animals the goosebumps are a defense mechanism. When in fear the hair ends rise up to make them look bigger in hopes of deterring predators. The rector pili muscles cannot be consciously controlled. 24. Tonsils. Other than the massive tissue situated at either side at the back of the human throat, there are a number of other tonsils like the adenoid tonsil, two palatine tonsils, the lingual tonsil and two tubal tonsils. Tonsils help in protecting the throat from inhaling foreign pathogens and against indigestion, but most of the time they prove to be more dangerous than beneficial. 23. Appendix. When primitive humans were largely food gatherers, vegetarians, the appendix helped in the digestion of food. Located in a pouch-like structure between large and the small intestine, the appendix basically assisted the latter in digesting cellulose and possibly also produced white blood cells. Though lying dormant, the appendix can cause a host of problems, like it can get infected causing appendicitis, an inflammation of the appendix. It causes abdominal pain, decreased appetite, nausea, etc., but most of the time people don't have the symptoms. 22. Wisdom teeth. Also called the third molar, it's developed between the ages of 17 and 25. According to researchers, the out-of-place wisdom tooth was useful to our ancestors for grinding down on plant tissues. But today our skulls have become smaller and the number of teeth has gone down because they are no longer required. 21. Subclavius muscle. The subclavius muscle is small triangular thick tendon that stretches between our first rib and our collarbone. Lying beneath our shoulders, the muscle helps carry our shoulders forward and downward, depress our shoulders. Subclavius muscle was useful when primitive humans walked on all four, but today it pretty much of no good use. The muscle is not found in everyone, some have only one, some two, and some none at all. 20. Darwin's point. Some people have a small folded bit of skin towards the top of their ear. It's called Darwin's point, and it's just a remnant of when our ears needed to be shaped differently for survival, as such a shape would have allowed us to hear distant sounds, alerting us to both danger and potential foods. 19. Preauricular sinus. Some people are born with small holes near their ears that are supposedly where our ancestors had gills. They're called preauricular sinus, and they don't do anything other than possibly get infected. 18. Adenoids. Adenoids are lymphoid tissue, like your tonsils, but aren't your tonsils, located in the throat at the very back of the nose. Supposedly they're part of the immune system and trap bacteria to help keep you healthy as a child, and then shrink and become useless as we age. However, some children have to have theirs removed and it doesn't seem to cause many issues. Even if yours don't make you miserable as a child, they're useless once you're an adult. Just shrunken little knobs of useless tissue, hanging out. 17. Gallbladder. The gallbladder is a pouch that holds bile, made by the liver, and slowly releases it into the digestive tract. It also makes painful stones and can cause problems from cancer, which spreads to necessary organs, and inflammation. Most people that have to have it removed don't notice much of a difference. 16. Redundancy organs. We have a lot of redundancy organs. So okay, technically they aren't useless, not even a little bit, they're actually quite awesome. But you can and could happily get by your whole life with one kidney, or only one ovary, or only one testicle. You only need one of these organs for them to perform their function. If you lose one, the other compensates, even in the case of testicles and ovaries when they need to regulate hormone production. 15. The palmaris muscle. This muscle runs from the elbow to the wrist and is a narrow muscle that we really don't use for anything. It's theorized that it was once used for hanging and climbing, but now surgeons will harvest it for reconstructive surgeries if needed. 14. Auricular muscles. There's a group of muscles that surround the ear and are used by some animals to move their ears around towards noises or to flatten them to show unhappiness. They're called auricular muscles, and humans have these too, but they serve no purpose. Mainly because we aren't cats. It's why some people can wiggle their ears, they've learned to control these muscles. 13. Plantaris muscle. At this point, about 9% of people are born without this muscle, which is in the foot. For those who are not, it's not really of any benefit. Unless you're a primate grasping things with your feet. Enjoying this list? Be sure to also check out 25 strange birth defects few kids are born with. 12. Plecosomy lunaris. Reptiles and birds have third eyelids, and humans just have a tiny bit of one left in the corner of our eye that does nothing. It's called the plecosomy lunaris, and it hangs out next to the tear duct. Plecosomy lunaris is also called the third eyelid, located in the corner of our eye next to our tear duct. It's a small folded fragment seen prominently when we move our eyes. The plecosomy lunaris is said to help the eye maintain tear drainage and also allows free rotation of our eyes. Without the plecosomy lunaris, our eye would limited movements because the eyeball will be attached directly to the conjunctiva. But even then its role is quite restricted because of its tiny size. Moreover, the existence of the plecosomy lunaris is not absolutely necessary for our survival. 11. The philtrum. The philtrum is the small dent between your nose and upper lip. When we're forming in the womb, it's where our face connects. When it doesn't connect correctly, babies are born with a cleft palate. Once that's done though, there's no need for it, despite millions of beauty gurus insisting we apply highlighter there. It's basically just a visible seam from manufacturing. 10. Body hair. We have explanations and uses for all the hair on our head, insulate our body temp, keep sweat out of our eyes. Beards could even play a role in sexual attraction. But what, exactly, is back and chest hair for? We don't really need body hair. 9. Jacobson's organ. There's an organ found in the olfactory system, think, smell, of mammals, amphibians, and reptiles that isn't functional in humans despite us having it. Known as Jacobson's organ, it was used to detect pheromones, but we don't use it or need it anymore. 8. Extra toes. We really don't need the fifth one, the pinky toe, on account of walking upright and on the ground, instead of clinging to and swinging from branches. All lesser apes need 5 toes for these things. Having 5 full toes basically just lets us pick up dirty laundry off the floor. We can walk and run just fine with less than 5. 7. Male uterus. Male what? Uterus. Male uterus. Actually, we're just making sure you're still paying attention. To clarify, no, men don't have a uterus. However, all humans start as female in the womb. While scientists still debate, it's thought that the prostatic utricle connected to the prostate in males came from the same ducts that develop into the female uterus. Basically, some view this utricle as remnants of what would have become their uterus. It basically serves no function, although that too, is debated. 6. Pyramidalis muscle. There's a tiny triangular muscle called the pyramidalis muscle that attaches to the pubic bone. It's sort of like a pouch. It's thought that it's a remnant from pouched mammals. Either way, we don't need it. 20% of the population isn't even born with one. But the rest of us, we just kept it. Like the receipt in the bottom of your purse from over a year ago. Never fear though, like most unneeded body parts, if you injure it, it still hurts. 5. Cervical ribs. Cervical ribs, located above the collarbone, occur in very few humans, but enough that it's a well-known thing. Gorillas and chimpanzees also have an extra set of ribs, instead of the standard 12 that most humans have. The extra set doesn't do anything, and most don't even know they have them. It could, however, cause neck pain in some people. 4. Paranasal sinuses. Paranasal sinuses are what most of us traditionally think of as our sinuses. As the name might suggest, they're the 4 that surround our nose, and generally feel cruddy during allergy season and get infected and stuff. Yeah, We don't need those. It's theorized that our ancestors had extra smell receptors there, which would have been helpful in a hunter-gatherer society. Not so much in a society that has progressed enough to invent Axe body spray. 3. Tailbone. Our tailbone is actually a group of fused vertebrae at the bottom of our spine. Also called the coccyx, these bones are what's left of our tails. No, really. We don't need them. Humans lost the need for tails when we learned to walk upright. It would be kinda cool to still have tails, but apparently the universe in its infinite wisdom doesn't let evolution work on the basis of you know what would be really cool? 2. Female vas deferens. These tubes are actually a reproductive body part that starts off the same in both men and women. In males, they become the vas deferens which carry sperm, in females, they're just dot tubes to nowhere. 1. Nipples. Nipple develops in a fetus even before the gender is determined. It's only on its 6th week that the male hormones such as testosterone start to take shape. At this point the male nipples stop to develop further but sometimes fat tissues accumulate around the nipple making them swell and become seemingly similar to female breasts. In pubescent boys, high levels of estrogen can also lead to swelling around the nipple making them looking larger. Though functionless, male nipples are pretty sensitive and can develop breast cancer.